So we got to review the Amazfit GTR, and here is the review after using it for a week. First impressions, out of the box, the GTR strap gave me a good old Casio watch feeling. However, the rubber strap quality was not that great to feel and felt a bit cheap, but the strap surely made the watch lightweight. Design-wise, the GTR is probably the best looking smartwatch under 10k price segment. We have the 42mm variant here with us, and there is another 47mm variant available if you prefer the bigger size. The watch has two buttons to the right which you can map as per your liking. The button quality is very good and what you will expect from a 10k watch. The metal casing looks and feels far more better than the plastic finish from the previous versions. One upgrade from the Verge Lite is the always on display. The most requested feature by Amazfit users, the AMOLED display is amazing. There were no issues looking at the watch from various angles and it worked fine in broad daylight as well. Although the always on display screen is not as visible in daylight, which is quite expected. The absence of oleophobic coating on the display is quite visible since it registers the fingerprints quite easily on the watch. The display quality on most of the Amazfit devices have been brilliant thanks to the AMOLED display, and so is the case with this GTR watch. The UI is similar to Verge Lite, and unfortunately this is also not Google Wear OS, which means less customizations and also less watch faces. All the necessary settings, which include the brightness, battery saver, flash and other stuff, can be made available by just swiping down on the screen. Swiping up will bring all the features that watch has to offer. Amazfit watches are very well known for their battery life, and with the GTR, the company claims at least 24 days of battery life. We weren't able to charge it to 100%, but at first boot, it was at 55% and it ran for a week easily with always on display enabled. Heart rate monitor and sleep monitor were quite accurate, although the step counter is not fully accurate since it counted some steps while I was on the bike. To be honest, it's very hard to find a smartwatch or a smart wearable which counts the exact number of steps. You can pair the device via the Amazfit app, which is similar to the Mi Fit application with all the watch faces available in the app itself. So what's the verdict? The GTR comes with 3 to 4 upgrades from the Verge Lite, which is available for 7000 rupees, and one of them is quite major, that is always on display. Obviously build quality, battery life are the other things which you can consider as well, but always on display for me personally is very important when it comes to a watch. Now, is the watch still at 10,000? Absolutely. With its sophisticated look and feel, the watch will stand out. And as for the battery life, no words here, as it was just perfect. The strap quality and the Amazfit OS basically. If this watch would have come with Google's Wear OS, this would have been an instant recommendation from my side. Amazfit OS is not bad as such. It will get the job done if health features are your priority. When it comes to notifications, Amazfit GTR will show you all the notifications that come on your phone, and that was quite seamless. But when it comes to calls, it will just show you who is calling. You won't be able to accept or reject the call from the watch itself. That obviously means that you won't be able to use the watch like to call someone or to talk to someone. You will have to take out your phone for that. You can only see the notifications. You cannot reply to any notifications, let it be messages or WhatsApp, anything like that. Only viewing notifications is possible. And that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and press the bell icon so that you will get notified next time I upload a video like this one. So yeah, thank you guys, thank you for watching.